Okay, so folks,
that was called noodling.
Noodling. Oh, do you know that one too?
Well, we didn't quite agree on one of the chords.
Yeah, that's right. So, welcome. Oh, John Marsh, sounds great. That's what I wanted to hear.
Thank you, John.
So, welcome to the 11th So Inclined live show, Facebook live show. And as you saw from our waiting room picture, the title of this show is Everybody's Reaching Out for Someone. And that's a song that we will get to later.
Yep.
But we're going to start with bluegrass, which I think we've done just about every time, but a lot of times anyway. This one is Don't Say Goodbye If You Love Me.
One, two, three.
Don't say goodbye if you love me, for it would make my heart overflow. Kiss my lips once, dare leave me, just don't say goodbye when you go. They tell me today you are going far away just to make you a name. Tell me that you're discontent and that you're searching for fame. Don't say goodbye if you love me, for it would make my heart overflow. Kiss my lips once, dare you leave me, just don't say goodbye when you go. Somehow I can't realize we're falling. I've grown so used to having you near. The strings in my heart love are breaking. I just can't say goodbye to you here. Don't say goodbye if you love me, for it would make my heart overflow. Kiss my lips once, dare you leave me, just don't say goodbye when you go.
Jim and Jesse tune. We do Jim and Jesse a lot because they have that
good harmony.
Harmony that we love. And it's also a duet harmony, which makes it perfect for us now. What is that funny instrument? The one with the hubcap.
Yeah, it's a guitar with a hubcap.
Show the audience your hubcap. There you go.
Voila.
There you go.
My guitar with the hubcap. It's a resophonic guitar, also known as a dobro. It's called a dobro in the same way that Kleenexes are called Kleenexes and not tissues.
Right.
The generic name is resophonic guitar. They were called dobros because the Dopero brothers made them and made them popular, and they called their instrument a dobro. This happens to be a Shearhorn that we saw Tim Shearhorn.
Made by Shearhorn.
In West Virginia at a music camp. And I love the sound of the guitars, the dobros that he makes. And so we ordered one and voila, here it is.
And we ordered it from Tim Shearhorn, who made it for Peggy. And after that, his name was bought out by some big company, I think maybe Gibson. Anyway, so now if you get a Shearhorn, you don't get one like this. But So our next song is one that Peggy wrote called Leaving Those Memories. And I just wanted to say a few words about this because Peggy and I have remarkable agreement on the musical issues, you know, choosing songs and things like that. But we don't agree at all about what a song is about.
No, that's not always
true. Well, that's not always true. But in this case, it's particularly peculiar because Peggy wrote it. But I don't think she knows what it's about. Now, the thing is this. Leaving those memories. So, why would somebody want to leave those memories behind if they weren't bad memories? No, she's going to tell you this is about the Adirondacks and all that pretty stuff.
Well, if you listen to the words, you'll hear that it's about the Adirondacks.
If you listen to the words, you'll hear. Okay, let's do the song.
All right.
There's not much you can do with your memories haunting you. They'll take your life. Lock it right away. They'll take your heart and your soul and leave you all alone. Just leave you with those dreams of yesterday. But now I'm leaving those memories, those dreams of yesterday. I'm going where the road is open wide. I'm going where I long to be when the air is fresh and my soul is free. Going where the road is open wide.
Fresh and clear.
That's where you're going too. But what are you leaving? All right. I mean,
it's about the Adirondacks. It's my.
I don't know. Okay, as you can tell, this marriage can't work.
Yeah.
But, so, yes, speaking of marriages and working, everybody's reaching out for someone is the name of this. And
we're not doing that yet.
No, we're not doing that yet. Okay. But we're trying, you're going to get a guitar now.
Oh, yeah.
Trying to pull together some songs with a common theme when we do these shows now. So we have four songs this time. And the theme is kind of like relationships and that sort of thing. And I think that if you try to apply that to everybody's reaching out, you have to ask, where's the relationship? And I guess if you're leaving something behind, it would be a relationship. But we're that's
everybody's reaching out. It's not the song we just did.
Leaving those memories is what I meant.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. No, everything else is completely makes sense. I mean, next one is Mark Arely's song, Compass and Companion. And, I just imagine a guy and his girlfriend driving home late at night after a gig. And this is how it goes. But it's a nice set. All right, now this last one, called Everybody's Reaching Out for Someone, is a song that we sang for our daughter's wedding, and that's why the picture on the wall, as well as the one in the waiting room, was a wedding, and it's, in fact, Megan's wedding, our daughter's wedding. And I think we told this story before, but it's
yes.
A good story. She's asked us to do this song for her wedding, which was a year and a half ago, 2 years ago?
It was January of 2019.
Right. And
almost 2 years ago.
We hadn't been doing music anymore, and we said to her, well, we can't do that. And she said, oh, sure, you can do it. You'll be great. Well, that was easy for her to say. So we had to work on it. But we did it. All right.
Wait, Rebecca. Rebecca bought a dobro when she was in college, because I play dobro, and she came home from college very proudly with this very nice dobro, and then I guess she never got around to learning it because she was busy learning to be a vet and to play polo. So she just, I don't know if you've seen her comment, but she said, have I trained the dobro that she left with us yet so that she can play it?
Ah, right.
So no, Rebecca, it's not yet trained. You have to do it yourself, I'm afraid. It's just like if I got a horse, I would have to train it myself. You probably wouldn't train
well,
it.
Well, I think she's had horses that somebody else trained, eh?
Well, that's
isn't that true.
That's
see true. That? So it's possible. So, you know, get that
Dobro
anyway,
whipped in shape.
It goes like this. Let's see how you start it.
Just like the trees along the river bend, reach up their branches to the sun up above. We spend a lifetime reaching for a friend, 'cause everybody needs someone to love. Everybody's reaching out for someone. Everybody's knocking at some door. And long before I ever found you, you're the one that I was reaching for. I've wanted you since the day my life began. I heard your footsteps running just beyond my mind. And ever since that moment I've been reaching for your hand, hoping you'll be reaching out for mine. Everybody's reaching out for someone. Everybody's knocking at some door. And long before I ever found you, you're the one that I was reaching for. Reaching out for someone. Everybody's knocking at some door. And long before I ever found you, you're the one that I was reaching for. And long before I ever found you, you're the one that I was reaching for.
Have a comment from Megan, of all people. Nice pick. Geez, where did we get that pick?
So and Megan, and a lot of hearts too from her.
Oh yeah, and a lot of hearts.
So we did this song at her wedding, at the very beginning of her wedding, and if you were able to listen to the words, "I've wanted you since the day my life began," I'm gonna cry talking about it.
Oh yeah, this is a good story.
And I, of course, am singing the most of the words. Rich is singing harmony with me, but I'm singing the main part of the words. And I got up there, and oh my heavens, I started choking up.
And well, that was, of course, a danger for the whole idea of playing at our own daughter's wedding.
So I cried when we rehearsed it at the venue where the wedding was. So I felt, and I heard it in my voice, and I felt myself choking up. And I'm singing along, and I said, "You will not cry. You will not cry."
And she didn't sing those words.
I didn't sing those words,
she
but
sang
I
the real words.
Said it to myself as I was singing the words of the song. And I got through the first verse, and I didn't cry. And got through the rest of the song. And I have to also say that Rich's stepbrother, Jeff Cordiano, was one of the guests at the wedding, and he, bless his soul, he was sitting there grinning from ear to ear because he was enjoying it so much. And I said, "Okay, I'm just going to focus on Jeff, and I'm going to get through this song." And so, thank you again, Jeff. That was, you got me through it. Thanks.
Well, you didn't tell the best part.
Oh, what was the best part?
The best part was afterwards, her sister said to her, "Oh, I saw you nearly break down there." And she said, "Oh, no, that was all part of the act."
Yeah, that is what I said.
All right, folks. Well, thank you for joining us. That's our show, short show this time, I guess.
Oh, no, I think it's about
normal 20 minutes.
Yeah, that's good.
Okay, so...
So thank you for being here again, and we plan to be back again next week, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it seems... Oh, you know why this week was so short? We had a concert in the middle of the week on Wednesday. This was a real concert. I mean, no, excuse me, you folks are real. But we were outside in front of an audience, and, you know, the whole weird thing about the virus and all that makes every public thing weird. Except for this. This is perfect.
This is perfect.
So it was kind of exhausting, though, packing up, you know, hours to pack up.
It was an hour and a half.
And drive there, and then it was a long show, and then pack up to come back. And I'm thinking, you know, all of that, and when I do my live shows, it's great. You know, I turn it on, I do the show, and then I turn it off.
And we love talking with you. Thank you again so much for being here.
Thank you for coming.
It's really fun.
And we'll see you next week.
Yep.
Okay.